Presented by Church Tech U, it's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, musical notation in ProPresenter 7. And why it may not be the best idea ever. Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I teach all about ProPresenter. My name is Paul Allen Clifford. And before we get started, why don't you join the over 11,000 other people that have subscribed to this channel, click the bell icon, and while you're at it, like, subscribe, and share. Well, part of that I already said. Anyway, from time to time I hear people say, hey, we've decided that we're going to show musical notation on our screens. And how can we do that in ProPresenter 7? Well, while it's possible, there are a couple of gotchas that I want you to be aware of in order for you to make a good decision on whether you should or not, even if you think you should. So let's head over to my computer and we'll take a look. So here we are in ProPresenter 7, and I have a song with musical notation that I have added into here. So that is, let me do a search for it. Here it is, A Mighty Fortress. It's actually the first one here, and when you click on it, you can see the preview. I'll tell you how I added it, and then we'll go from there. So, added that in. You'll notice this one looks a little bit different from this one, and so, first thing, I just did a search on musical notation for hymns, and found a site that had all it had was PowerPoint. So I just imported the PowerPoints as images, and then we're good to go. So let me show you what they look like. So we'll go here, and now let me go ahead and do this. Hey there, aspiring ProPresenter Pro. Are you tired of getting tangled up in tech trouble? Want to impress your congregation with mind-blowing visuals? Well, look no further. Introducing ProPresenter 7 training at Church Tech U, your secret weapon for unlocking ProPresenter's full potential. Join me as I dive into the world of captivating presentations, smooth transitions, and jaw-dropping effects. From beginner basics to advanced tips and tricks, I've got you covered. Don't miss out on this amazing opportunity. Visit churchtechu.com/free trial for a free month now. Did I mention it's free? And revolutionize your ProPresenter game. Your congregation will thank you. See, this is one of the problems, is on the stage screen, you can't actually see any words whatsoever, no notation whatsoever. So you would have to do a screen preview. So that's one problem. Now for another problem, let me go ahead and show it to you this way. So I'm showing this to you, and what I should have done was had some background here. Let me click on a background just to hide the ProPresenter interface. So there you go, and on your computer that might look fine, but I want you to notice a couple of things. First off, the version that I downloaded, these are shaped notes. And those are used for primarily for congregations that don't use musical instruments. I'm not here to talk about whether that's a good idea or a bad idea. I just want you to know that that's one reason why you might do that. Here, let me put a background up here. So that might be why you want to do that, but notice right here, it's kind of hard to see what the shapes are. And depending on how far away from the screen you are, it might be, again, difficult to see what the shapes are. So that's another issue. Let's say you're not using shape notes. It might be very difficult to tell how the staff is, where the notes are on the staff as well. If someone doesn't have perfect vision, that could be difficult as well. So I want you to be aware of that, that the lines are going to be very difficult to read. The shapes, if you've got shaped notes, are going to be kind of hard to read. And that is with, I've got a 16 by 9 screen here, and 1080p. That is with that zoomed in. So if instead I had a 4 by 3 screen, and therefore it's probably going to be much lower resolution, probably 800 by 600 or 1024 by 768 versus my 1080p. Now if I show this, notice how I've got twice as many lines here, and therefore the stuff is smaller. So that's another problem, because if it's smaller, it's going to be even harder to read. Also, notice the number of words on the screen. When I blew this up to where it was large enough to see a little bit better on the 16 by 9 screen, that's just one line. So I would have to have another slide for that one line, so I'm going to be changing a lot more frequently. If you have a church where you're used to showing four lines, or maybe even six, I wouldn't do more than four generally, but some churches do more, it's going to be jarring to go from four lines of text to one. So that's another downside. So I just want you to be aware of all those downsides before we go ahead and talk about how to bring these in. So if I go into Chrome and let me add a new Chrome window here, and I'll show you where I got this. So here we go. Okay, so here we are on the paperless hymnal, and it is where I got this stuff, but notice they do have a 16 by 9 version. You can get that. You can download all these for various amounts of money and so on. They do have a free option, and that's the one that I got. So let's click on free stuff here. Okay, so notice I just clicked on the first one, A Mighty Fortress. Maybe we go All Hail the Power of Jesus' Name, and notice that has downloaded. So I'm going to need to do exactly the same thing that I would normally do with a PowerPoint to bring that in. So I've got two options. I could either bring it in using the built-in PowerPoint import utility in ProPresenter. So File, Import, PowerPoint, and then navigate to where that is. I think it's in my Downloads folder right here. And this is going to start up PowerPoint and import it. So you do have to have PowerPoint on your computer in order for this to work. So I need to choose the library that this is going to go into. So let's go to Senior Adult. Maybe I'd have a hymn library, what have you, something like that. And then we give it just a second to do this. Notice that it is taking a second to fire up PowerPoint. And there we go, we've brought that in. So that's one way to do it. if you don't have PowerPoint on the same computer, then the way that I would go about this is I would download just something that can read a PowerPoint file, because from this particular site, these are just images. So you're not going to be bringing in text and editing it. This is all just image files. It's bringing in here, let me mouse over that. So it is bringing in the title as part of a text file, but when we go down here and edit this slide, you'll notice that that's it. So, you know, there's the text box, rectangle text box. There's another one from paperlesshymnal.com, but the actual major piece of it is this image right here. So if they have a slightly different version than you have, I know some denominations use slightly edited versions to make them sound a little bit more modern, you know, whatever. Sometimes it's theological disagreement. Well, you're out of luck. You've got to find them somewhere else. So no saying, oh, this is perfect, except for one word, which I would love to change. Nope, you're kind of out of luck there. So one other thing that I think that may be a subtle problem here is, and this is personal, well, it's personal preference with a reason. So I would do the exact opposite of this. I would have put this on a black background and have the everything white. And the reason for that is a screen is not a piece of paper. And our eye is going to be attracted to the light as opposed to attracted to the dark. So here you've got this big open spot right here where it's kind of, it's going to attract your eye there. Ideally, I'd love this to be cropped, but it's not. So it's less than ideal. I don't think that you actually get a whole lot out of adding in the musical notation, and in fact you lose a good chunk of stuff when you add in the musical notation. Oh, one other thing that I should mention, all of my screens are 16:9, but when it brought in this, it's a 4:3 PowerPoint presentation, so I would need to go right click, go to edit slide, and change the size of this to one of my actual screen resolutions here. And so in doing that, that's something else I'd have to do again, unless I paid for the 16:9 version. So that could be something that maybe you just want to consider. Okay? If you like this content, you'd probably like my ProPresenter 7 Quick Start course, so head on over to tdm.fyi/pro, the number 7, and Quick Start. Give me your name and email address, and I will make a login for you for free. Until next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.